He was on top of the world after helping England lift the Jules Rimet trophy in 1966. Yet he was having to look over his shoulder at a teenage rival for his position with his club and eventually his country.
I played four games for England schoolboys, and of course, quite a few big clubs start sniffing around, and Manchester United and Arsenal wanted me to sign. But because of my association with the club, my father said, look, you know, I think you'd be better staying at home, signing for the club you love. And, you know, I did say, well, look, you know, they've got England's best goalkeeper. It's going to be a bit tough. And he said, look, you know, it's better to be happy and contented. And there was no doubt in my mind that that's what I wanted to do anyway, because I was a Leicester lad. So, you know, I decided to sign on £8 a week as a 15-year-old.
I knew Peter had signed professional forms for the City, and I could see, I watched him work, and I could see that he was going to be an excellent goalkeeper.
When England games were on, they didn't postpone the league matches, so when Banksy went off to the England squad, you know, I got a chance to play the odd game or two, and certainly I made my debut in against Everton when I was 16 and a half.
And the Leicester City goal, one of the most promising, if not the most promising, young goalkeeper in the country, Peter Shilton.
I was very ambitious and I did want to do well, and you know, I had a couple of conversations with the manager and basically said, look, you know, I'm not going to get in the team while Gordon's here. You know, if there's a chance to move on, I feel as though I could do the job, but, you know, it's up to you, really.
And a fine save by Shilton.
You've got two guys. One had only played about one game for the first team, but was a tremendous potential. The other one, you got probably a reputation as almost the best goalkeeper in the world. And you've got to make a choice between the two.
I was absolutely in shock when he told me that they'd had a meeting and what would I think about leaving the club. He actually said to me, we think we've had the best out of you. It didn't go. Some of the words that he said didn't go down very well with me.
It was a big challenge for me. It wasn't easy, really, for, you know, to take over. But, you know, I learnt a lot from that. And, you know, I don't think you get many 17-year-olds in modern-day football playing that way.
And Shilton in great form. That's why Leicester were able to let Gordon Banks leave the club.
If the dilemma over Banks and his departure to Stoke was at least...
Great is bandied about quite a lot nowadays, but I think Peter Shilton was one of the great goalkeepers.
Oh, and Shilton, how did he push that one round? It this time, and what a save! What a monumental save by Peter Shilton!
Probably the best goalkeeper we've produced in British football. I thought Shilton was magnificent.
Once again, this time to McDougall, and another magnificent save by Peter Shilton. Number one.
I actually got involved with a company called Admiral, and they brought out an all-white goalkeeping strip, and it was quite the beginning of what is now a massive business. You know.
All-white kit's not ideal for goalkeepers, is it?
I don't think it really matters.
Gets a bit dirty.
Well, I used to say my defence was that good, I never used to have to dive around too much in it, so that's what they used to tell me.
This classic David and Goliath battle about to get underway. Leatherhead the side to kick off, and should you be watching this match in black and white, Leicester are wearing